right, going over some of the basics of brushless conversions. I know a lot of you guys already know all this information, can probably teach me some things. So if you want, you could just skip to the time on the screen and jump to the first drive with the brushless system. All right, we got the Arrma Vorteks 550 Mega. We're going to be doing a brushless swap in it today. We're going to be upgrading the steering servo. I'm going to be going over some of the basics to brushless swapping your RC. We're going to be using a Hobbywing 10BL120 brushless system. We'll be using the 3660 3700 kV motor. It has a 120 amp ESC. For the steering servo, we're going with the Eco Power WP120S. I've used a lot of Eco Power servos before. This is kind of their speed servo, faster one, for their 1/10 scale. Should have plenty of speed and power for the Vorteks. We're also doing a stock replacement of the servo saver. I broke the factory one at the skate park. Wasn't bashing it too hard, but I heard these are kind of a weak point. I never broke one on my Gorgon or my Fury, and I bashed those pretty hard, but probably not going to be doing too much more skate park bashing with the Vorteks. So I'm not too worried about upgrading it to like a metal servo saver or anything like that. Also going to install this Rocket RC 40 millimeter fan. Keep all the electronics running cool. So from the factory, the Arrma Vorteks uses a 550 brushed motor, a 14 turn. So when dealing with brush motors, they're categorized by can size and the amount of turns on the motor. The turns on the motor indicate speed or torque. The lower turn numbers are higher speed motors, with the higher turn motors being higher torque motors. On brushed motors, you only have two wires coming from the motor to the ESC. Factory, it uses a 2-in-1 ESC, so the electronic speed control and the receiver for your transmitter are all built into one. What we're going to be using will have a separate ESC and receiver for your transmitter. Your electronic speed control is what sends the power from your battery to the motor. It regulates your throttle depending on your input from your transmitter. So this is our brushless motor we're going to be using. The advantages of running a brushless motor is generally higher power, they run cooler, and they're more efficient with your battery. The size of this is a 3660. So your first two numbers, the 36 is your width of your motor, 36 millimeters. And then the 60 is your length, 60 millimeters. On a sensorless brushless motor, you just have three wires coming off your motor that you plug into your ESC or you solder in. This motor is 3700 kV, so it'll be 3700 RPM per volt. We're going to be running this on 3S. So with RC cars and LiPo batteries, you'll commonly see 2S, 3S. What that stands for is 3.7 volts per cell. Or S. That is the storage voltage. When they're fully charged, they're 4.2 volts per cell. So a fully charged 3S battery will be 12.6 volts. So with our 3700 kV motor, we'll be 46,620 RPMs, hypothetically. All right, that's some of the just bare basics of brushless swapping in RC motors. All right, let's get wrenching. We'll be right back. so we got everything swapped over. Jumping ahead a little bit, got the wheels on, got the servo saver on, and the links hooked back up. Gonna go over some troubleshooting with your initial setup. All right, I have my transmitter bound using a radio link transmitter. So first thing I notice is my steering is the wrong direction. So I'm going to reverse my steering channel. It's different depending on which controller you're using. Just noticing now if my controller gets too close to the receiver, it seems to not really function that great. But like a foot away, works perfect. That new servo's quick. All right, throttle. Okay, so tires are spinning the correct way, but it still thinks normal throttle. It does brakes the first time I hit it, so it thinks it's reverse. So I gotta switch it on my controller. Alright, the throttle and brakes are working correctly, but now the tires are spinning the wrong direction. There are two options. Since this isn't a censored motor, the easiest way is just to reverse two of the wires on the ESC, or you could go in through programming and reverse the rotation of the motor that way. I'm just going to swap two wires. Alright, tires are spinning the correct direction. Throttle and brakes are working correctly. Alright, it's ready for a test drive.
Alright, got the Arrma Vorteks out for its first drive after doing the brushless conversion. Got the new steering servo in as well. I don't know if I said in the build portion, but I built it with a 19-tooth pinion. We're going to start out on 2S and then we'll do a speed test on 3S. Hoping for over 50. All right, let's get out and have some fun. New steering servo's very fast. Definitely a lot more punch on 2S than it had before. Alright, do our speed pass on 2S. We did 24 miles an hour stock. See what we do now. Thank you. being two-wheel drive, you only have two-wheel brakes now. Gotta remember that with the extra speed. Let's see what we got. 39 miles an hour, 2S. All right, she's gonna scream on 3S. All right, 60 foot drag time, 2S. I could probably turn up the punch settings and programming, but kind of nice for the drag start that it doesn't wheelie. .09, 33 miles an hour, .99G. Not too bad for not a drag car. Let's do a full 1/10 scale pass. All right, 1/10 scale drag pass. .359, 36 miles an hour, 1.03G. All right, let's toss the 3S battery in. All right, first run, 3S. Yeah, she's a ripper. All right, 3S speed pass. Let's bring it in and see what we got. .57 miles an hour. Very impressive. Didn't have to go too easy on the throttle. Didn't want to flip over backwards. Didn't even really need that wheelie bar. This thing's a certified ripper. Let's do one more. I don't think I'll hit a 60, but... I guess if the wind conditions are right, oh wheelie. .57 again, backed it up. 60 foot drag time, 3S. .21, 27 miles an hour, 1.17G. 10 scale drag pass, 3S battery. Definitely got a little squirrely there, but stayed on throttle, kept it straight for the most part. .319, 43 miles an hour, 1.17G. Definitely not a drag car. Definitely need the punch turned up off the launch. Probably some better tires then too. But still fun out here.
All right, so that was a lot of fun doing the brushless conversion on the Arrma Vorteks. Just going over some basic info before you do your first brushless conversion. There's lots of places online where you can find a lot more in-depth information. As for the Vorteks, I'm very happy how it turned out. 57 miles an hour on 3S, 39 on 2S. Doesn't get hot at all. The new steering servo is super fast. It was pretty stable at speed. You didn't have to baby the throttle too much to get the top speed runs. All right, I hope you found this video helpful. Thanks for watching.